Hi, my name is Gurkamal Chatta, and I'm the chief of genitourinary oncology at Roswell Park. So I think when we, broach the whole subject of advanced bladder cancer, firstly, it's important to distinguish it from locally advanced cancer, because there, the horse is only slightly outside the barn, because those group of patients can be cured. But when it's truly advanced or it's gone to multiple different places, most of us would admit that you can't cure the cancer, but you can control it, and that control can be very meaningful for a long period of time. And depending on how they respond to the different treatments, and again, the two main treatments here would be chemotherapy and immunotherapy, people can live for 5-6 years. So just because we can't cure it, it's important for patients to know that we can control it for a long time and really provide them, with a meaningful quality of life. Secondly, there are advances in treatment that are always ongoing. Just in the last 3 years, there are two brand new drugs that have been approved for advanced bladder cancer, which is over and above the chemotherapy and immunotherapy that I already mentioned. In addition, people are also trying combinations of drugs to see if we can provide, a greater level of control for a longer period of time. So let's talk about localized cancer. Now, just with surgery or surgery and chemotherapy alone, cure rates could be 60 to 70 to 80%. Once the cancer is locally advanced, probably the cure rates drop to about 30 to 40%. And when it's advanced, the median survival, meaning that's what happens with 50% of the patients, is probably 3 years. But then there is a small group of people, and we don't quite understand who they are, that 5% of them alive are alive at 10 years. And so really what we are constantly trying to do is at any given time point, can we keep on improving the batting average?